I have to be honest, I was not aware of our energy source before. Like, I did not know that we're importing our energy from off-island. And it was highlighted to me during the past typhoon that we had. The families that we left in Guam had to experience no power for a month. And it made me think that, oh, we can do something about it.
Guam, like all the rest of the islands in Micronesia, are dependent on import of energy sources, so fuel and so forth. So we would like to see hydrogen generation become a prominent source of energy in our region.
You know, there's a lot of things that, you know, DOE National Labs do that really could help with the island, or things that maybe the island can learn to do. Here's a lot of it is renewable power, clean energy.
So PNL is one of the leaders on hydrogen production, utilization, and storage. Right now we are teaching them the basics of how to run the equipment needed to test the electrolysis of seawater.
So there is a huge difference in the electrolysis of seawater, and it primarily comes in the form of chlorine. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to model the system of electrolysis in a seawater medium to try to optimize the process of hydrogen production.
In the lab, we are producing hydrogen, and we can notice that by seeing the bubbles on the electrodes. We're not exactly extracting hydrogen yet, but we're understanding what the interactions are needed to make that hydrogen gas.
Now that we are in this program, I am more aware that we have resources in Guam that can be used for clean energy that is really helpful for the energy resource in Guam.
What it means for me personally to be in this program is that I am able to expand my knowledge that I get from here and to be able to share it back to my community. And for me, as a civil engineering student who wants to be an environmental engineer, who wants to dedicate my life to renewable energy and sustainable construction, I want our island to be as environmentally friendly as possible. And that would mean having the knowledge of this fundamental science.